It's Thursday night basketball here on ESPN as we get set for a Pacific Division matchup between the Golden State Warriors and the LA Clippers. As we get things started, who on the Clippers do you think they need to keep an eye out for here tonight, Jeff?
Mike, I've heard all about Lob City. It isn't about Lob City. It's about Point Guard City. When Chris Paul came to the Clippers, he turned them from a entertaining team into a big-time championship-level team. Why? Because he can probe the defense. He knows when to pass and when to shoot. This guy is an intense competitor that's the envy of every other team in this league.
2 points.
The Warriors, coming off a tough loss in their previous game against Cleveland, they struggled with their perimeter defense. So many easy three-pointers.
That looked like practice out there. There was no hand in their face. There was no contest. There was no running them off the three-point line and making them put it on the ground and try to drive it into the teeth of the defense. This was just poor defensive effort and mentality. A really disappointing loss.
Redick's shot from three-point land, no good. Throws it down. What a play.
A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
We talk so much about DeAndre Jordan's defense and his shot blocking. This guy, though, Jeff, he's a solid, efficient scorer.
Because he knows what shots he can make. He's going to score on dunks, on layups, and within 3 feet of the basket. He's a great pick-and-roll player, rolling to the rim, catching the lob. I like it when people know who they are and are not constantly trying to reinvent themselves where their strength now becomes a weakness.
First free throw, perfect.
Bogut is a rare combination of shot blocker, rebounder, and passer for a big man. You usually don't see those three in combination.
A ferocious slam.
Oh, that's a sweet finish right there. Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Curry from outside, a three-pointer. Griffin the rebound. Griffin for another attempt. It's good. A two-pointer. And Blake Griffin with 6 points already in the first quarter. Green jump shot. Knocks down the three-pointer. He scored 6 three-pointers in their previous game against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Paul into the front court. Telegraph that pass for the turnover. Terrific rejection. Crawford jumper. Nails it. That's a two-pointer. The Clippers down by two.
And in their last game, the assist total wasn't where it needed to be. Today, it's a completely different story.
You know, Jeff, most people recognize Jamal Crawford as a great scorer, but it takes a special talent to be able to be instant offense off the bench.
Yeah, and I think it takes a special mindset, Mike, to be able to see yourself in a six-man role when oftentimes he can say, I'm better than the guy that's starting ahead of me. He can hit you with so many ways to score. The three-point shot, the pick-and-roll game. He's a great free throw shooter. He's one of the all-time great streak scorers.
Moves around the defender in the paint. And Stephen Curry with a two-pointer. And Los Angeles calls a 20-second timeout. We look at Chris Paul. We'll look at the numbers he puts in night in, night out. But he really changed the perception of the Clipper franchise. They were a laughingstock for a lot of years in the NBA. He completely turned that perception around.
And they earned that perception about being a laughingstock through inept play, multiple coaching changes. But Chris Paul coming there, to me, gave legitimacy. And it's been beautiful to watch for the parity of the league.
Curry against Paul. Curry for three. Curry's unable to hit from downtown. Paul the jumper. The Clippers with the offensive rebound for a second chance opportunity. Gets to the rim, and Klay Thompson with a nice play.
2 points.
Golden State's leading Los Angeles by a score of 18 to 12. Paul the jumper. Green against Pierce. Goes to the goal. Puts it in.
Green. 2 points.
And that's it for the first quarter. Golden State's up by 8. Stay with us for more NBA action after this short break.
Remember, fans, if our team reaches 100 points and wins tonight, everyone gets
Griffin's looking to do damage in the paint. Let's it go. The Clippers, impressive putback. What timing.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with the nice dunk.
Curry on the drive to the rim. Gets it to go. And Stephen Curry with 10 points.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Careless ball handling. Stripped and stolen by Bogut. Stuffs it in the rim.
This is an absolute joke. This defense is horrible. You've got to stay between your man and the basket versus getting broken down off the dribble.
Crawford for two. The Clippers with the offensive rebound for it. Oh, what a play!
This season, a huge season for Draymond Green. He was so versatile last year, now has the big contract. Perhaps feels a little pressure that he's got to perform this year.
Money Green is my new nickname for him, Mike. But he deserved it. He earned it. His play, his versatility, his competitive juice had such a huge impact on the Warriors winning. And I don't think there has to be anything to change for his formula of success. He should not feel more pressure to score. Just continue to do his job and do it at a very, very high level.
Curry jump shot. Won't go. And they can't extend the lead into double figures. He got hit by Curry.
To number 30, Stephen Curry.
Doc Rivers is making a few substitutions.
Los Angeles. That's his first personal foul. Team foul number one.
Inside. Can hit. The Clippers with the offensive rebound for another possession.
And they've been coming up with the ball consistently when it's coming off the backboard. They've done a great job on the boards early in this game.
And Harrison Barnes will go to the line with under 3 minutes to go in the second. Knocks down the first one.
I really liked how Harrison Barnes adapted to going back in the starting lineup. He didn't play as a first option type of offensive player. He played off the other great players on his team, and he defended with passion.
To the basket, knocks it down. Chris Paul's 2 for 5 from the field. For three, the wide open shot. It's good, and they extend the lead to double figures. Stephen Curry with 13 points.
Right from the start here in the first half, they've made a conscious effort to move the basketball around and get quality shots.
Paul's unable to hit from beyond the three-point arc. Paul for two, lets it go. Paul shot off the mark.
Poise and precision will get you a better quality shot than that. That's a bailout shot. That's a, I'm going to try to get us back in and be a hero type of shot.
Chris Paul, he is desperate to get to a finals, desperate for a championship, but his team not able to get past the second round. What does he have to do to take them there, Jeff?
Well, Chris Paul is a great player. Oftentimes, how far you advance in the playoffs is just as much about who you play with and who you play against as it is how you play individually. Chris Paul has nothing to be ashamed about. This is a team that could win it all.
Curry's not able to hit the three.
That's a shooting turnover right there. You shot it too quick, had no chance of going in. That's just like a turnover.
Hits the three. Los Angeles is 1-for-5 from three-point territory.
What a beautiful stroke. Right down the heart of the basket. Big time three.
3 points. The assist from number
Paul. Looking to duke the defense, draws the double team. Griffin's looking for position in the paint. To the rim.
And Luke Bamamute with the bucket.
You want to keep attacking the basket and get layups around the rim. That's how you score consistently.
Griffin brings it across. Tries it again. The Clippers with the offensive rebound to keep it alive. Curry on the drive.
Bogut against Jordan from deep in the corner.
Oh, nice rebound by Jordan.
There's a 5-second differential between the shot clock and game clock.
The assist from
Curry,
three,
bringing it up. Curry from downtown. He's left open. Chris Paul with his 7th assist of the night.
The assist from number 3, Chris Paul.
And he just flips it up as time winds down. And that'll do it. First half comes to an end. The Warriors up by 4. All right, let's give it over. Welcome back to the Oracle Arena for the second half. This is Mike Breen, and along with me is Jeff Van Gundy. Golden State's got a slim lead as the third quarter gets underway. But, Jeff, this one's anyone's game right now.
It is very closely and hotly contested. I like how both teams are playing. They've just got to try to get a little bit more separation with some sound, quality possessions.
Oh, nice-looking drop step there. Griffin has the double team close in. From downtown, and Harrison Barnes with the jump shot. Knocks it down for 3. He's averaging 11 points per game this season.
There are not many players that shoot that straight on 3 like he does.
Redick from downtown, nobody near him. Chris Paul with his 8th assist of the night.
Listen, Mike, they didn't have a lot of assists in the last game, and sometimes we can say, well, they didn't pass the ball. Sometimes you have to make shots. You can be passing the ball well, and you miss the shot. Well, today they're passing the ball well, and they're making. That's why their assists are way up.
Curry jump shot. Unable to convert the 3. Golden State's leading Los Angeles by a score of 40-36. Crawford for 2, shoots away. It's good. And Jamal Crawford with 6 points.
Hey, you can only control what you can control. The defense there was great. It was just a better shot.
Puts it up. That's good. 4-point lead for Golden State.
And while there are plenty of things you could point to as to why they're winning right now, this is just a matter of great offense. They put a lot of points on the scoreboard.
Crawford against Barnes. To the basket, flips it up, puts it in. That's a 2-pointer. LA's shooting 50% from the field.
Green
finds the wide open look for three.
Green's off the mark from downtown.
Thompson jump shot.
And he nails it.
A long two.
Klay Thompson with 6 points.
The ball movement in this game has been phenomenal, forcing a lot of defensive rotations and ultimately a lot of passes leading to direct scores.
The assist from number six.
Green fires for three. Green shot from behind the arc won't go.
It just shows you once again the volatility of the three-point shot. Made a lot of three-pointers in the first half and now can't seem to buy a basket here in the second.
It'll count if it goes. The Warriors with the offensive rebound for a second chance opportunity. That's a three-pointer. The defense nowhere near him.
That's what I'm talking about.
Golden State's leading Los Angeles by a score of 47-44. That's a foul. Easy call. Doc Rivers is switching a few players here.
Team foul number two. First foul in the last 2 minutes. Substitutions, LA.
Can't hold on to the ball. Paul on the drive. And the rebound taken by Green.
He's averaging 9 boards per game this season.
And he throws it down.
A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
Clearly a foul called against the Warriors. That last foul means they're in the penalty, so it's time for free throws.
The Warriors are now in the penalty.
And he connects on the first free throw. The Clippers with a strong finish on the hustle play. Puts it up from downtown. And Stephen Curry with a pretty shot from three.
He's got 18 points in this game.
Excellent balance. Beautiful release. Knocked it out.
Paul. And here's the double. Wide open for three. The Clippers with the offensive rebound for a new 24. It down.
You don't want to be a guy who misses that easy of a shot. That should be a free 2 points.
Curry fires up another three. And Stephen Curry with the jumper puts it in.
Nice follow through on that shot. Gets the three to drop.
Number three.
Paul draws the double. Terrific block by Green. Lots of room there. Nails the three.
You don't have a lot of room over there in the corner. You got to get your feet set, get on balance, and stroke.
Out of bounds, ref says it'll be Clippers ball. Taking it baseline at the rim. Nails it.
That's just a nice layup right there.
Bogut's trying for position in the paint. Hits the three. A huge shot from downtown.
Oh, the long three-pointer. But when you have confidence, you can shoot it from anywhere. He shot it from downtown and knocked it home.
Throws it right back at him. Jordan fires. And a nice finish at the basket. Double team closing in. Puts it in. Plus the foul. Able to connect on the free throw. Quarter winding down, he just flips it up. And the third quarter comes to an end. Golden State's up by 4. We'll be right back with more. As we get set to start the fourth quarter, both offenses in this very close game have put on clinics.
Oh, this has just been an offensive juggernaut at both ends of the floor. The efficiency, the execution has been something to just marvel at.
Thank you. throws it down. What a play!
Oh, that's a sweet finish right there. Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Golden State's leading Los Angeles by a score of 64 to 56.
The assist from number 11, Jamal Crawford.
Curry on the drive, takes another shot, nails it.
3 points.
Sloppy ball handling. Authoritative dunk.
You're not winning late in a close game playing that type of defense, allowing the ball to go in direct line drive right at the basket.
On the drive, it's good. 4-point game.
The assist from number 11, Jamal.
Puts it up for three. Great offensive rebound. Bad turnover.
That's the last thing they needed right there, Mike. Critical mistake.
Bogut from downtown. Bogut's attempt for three. No good.
They're green light shooters, yellow light shooters, and red light shooters. That guy's a red light shooter shooting a green light shot. Are you kidding me? That's too early in the clock. Block! That kind of play, Mike, makes a statement.
Hits, and he puts it down.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
Curry on the drive. Oh, he beats the defender. Strong to the goal. Big offensive rebound. From 3-point, Curry with a touch, puts it in.
Better late than never. Finally, a lead change in this game. Now maybe we'll get some of that back and forth action that we expect to see in NBA basketball.
Hall against Curry. Getting to the basket, a pretty Euro step. Knocks it down. 1-point game. Puts it down. What a play.
And your first priority as a defense is to force them to shoot jump shots. When there's a drive, there's got to be help, and make them kick the ball out to the perimeter and then close out.
Can't get the layup to go.
Hey, even though they missed that shot, that defense is not.
Swats that one away.
Are you kidding me? That's the way to protect the basket.
Oh, sinks the two-pointer.
4-2. The assist from number 23.
From way downtown. Strong on the offensive glass. Oh, he knocks it down.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy open two-point jump shot.
It's good, and one.
Down the stretch, every possession counts to get. Give up a touch foul, a dunk, and a possible three-point play is inexcusable.
And he does it. A three-point play. And Golden State's called for their first team foul.
Hey, fourth quarter, close game. You've got to know time, score, penalty situation. They did. They had a foul to use. They used it. Good basketball play.
Into the paint, attacks the basket, puts it in. 4-point game. Coughs it up.
What was he thinking on that play? Who was he trying to pass to?
Reddick's 3-point shot won't go.
It's a make or miss lead. You make, you win. You miss, you lose. Throws it down. In close games, you cannot allow the dribble to break you down and get right to the basket. The individual defender has to do a good job, but the help defense is late as well.
To the rim. Jumper off the mark that time.
You have to make the defense work. That shot bailed the defense out. You gave them a possession off instead of making them work each and every time down the court to defend you.
Oh, he's wide open. Puts it in from way downtown.
You need guys late in games to finish off games that will do multiple things. Help, rotate, and finally close out and contest. You can't leave people wide open.
First free throw, good. Goes one for two. They now lead by four. And LA calls timeout as time is running down here in the fourth.
You don't need a three right now. Attack the basket, get the quick two, or get to the free throw line, which allows you to set your defense and try and force a turnover.
No one even close. He fires for two. And there's the foul. They had to stop that clock. This is the first. Oh, he missed both free throws. They're still up by four, however. And Doc Rivers calls time as we wind down here in the fourth quarter. This game is finished. The final score is 79-75. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thank you.
Here we go with the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Warriors emerge victorious. On behalf of EA